Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to dynamically set the values for your axis on bar charts and line charts, Power BI. Stay tuned. All right, so dynamic axis values on charts, line charts, and bar charts, what? You can't do that in Power BI. Sure you can. I'm gonna show you how to do it with some help, from two friends, with some help from Chris and Scott. You can hit them up on Twitter. Scott blogs, I think the Tiny Lizard or something like that. Scott actually provided the foundation for what we're gonna do. So big ups to you, Scott. He kind of gave us a starting space. And then Chris actually posed the question. So Chris called me up and he was like, hey Patrick, what I like to do is I like to provide a filter list for my customers. And when they choose this filter list, the axis on a bar chart or line chart will change based on what they select. I was like, what? How do you do that? So the first thing I did, right, I went to my favorite search engine, Bing, and I searched and I landed on Scott's blog. And I'll give you the comments, give a link to the blog post down below. And so Scott walks you through on how to get to the point, and at the bottom he goes, you could use some Power Query stuff and unpivot to do it, and maybe I'll follow up with it. And so I took his blog post and I expanded on it, and I'll show you how to do it with Power Query, and that's actually what I'm gonna show you in this video. And so we were able to produce this solution for Chris, and Chris kind of enhanced it a little bit with just a single pivot. I was doing two pivots, I don't know why. Oh, data type problem. So I'll walk you through all this, but it was a pretty cool solution. So the best way for me to show you is, you guys know how I like to do it, let's head over to my laptop. All right, so I have this Power BI desktop, right? And I have a few tables, nice little clean model that I created. And what I'd like to do is have a bar chart. So let me create a new page. Let me give you a sense of what I like to do here. I'm gonna create a new page and I'm just gonna get sales. So I got sales, and what I would like to have on it, if I go to product, I click color. And so now what I'd like to give my end users the ability to do is toggle between color and product. If they're in read-only mode, right, they can't modify the bar chart. They can't select the values for the axis because they're in read-only mode, right? If they have edit permissions, they can change it, like me right now, right? I can get rid of color and then I can drag product there. And now product is on the axis. And so my first, you know, when Chris first asked me about this, I was like, Chris, why don't you just do drill through, right? Why don't I just take color and drop it there and then enable drill? Then I can see all the products that are, you know, that black, or I can drill up and see all the products that are red. He was like, that's cool, Patrick, I get it. But my end users would really like to see it the other way, where I had those options. If I had product and color in a slicer, and you could choose it and it changed what was on the axis. I started thinking, and then I landed on Scott's blog, right? And like I said, the link to it will be down in the comments below, all right? Below. So how did I solve this problem? Well, Scott kind of walks us through it, of how it works and everything. So let me show you, you know, how I did it with Power Query, and then bring it back over to Scott's blog post. All right, and then we'll finish it up with his steps. All right, check it out. So what I did was, let's go ahead and delete this, and we're gonna go and edit, going to edit queries. Now, this is gonna add a little more data to your model. So if your model's already bloated, or if it's, you know, reached that limit that you can put out in PowerBI.com, you need to think about this. You need to consider this before you use this approach, okay? So what I would do is, since I wanna pivot this, since I wanna change the axis based on what's in my product table, the first step is I'm gonna copy my product table, all right? And I'm gonna duplicate it. So right click, choose duplicate, and I'm gonna change the name to unpivot. Got it, right? So what I'm gonna do, I may have already told you guys, is I'm gonna take the column headers, put them on rows as attributes, and then display the corresponding values for the products and the colors. So let me show you. So the first thing you wanna do is make sure the two columns that you're unpivoting are the same data type. Mine say they are, but I'm gonna go ahead and, you know, just err on the side of caution. You know me, right? Not lazy, just really efficient. All right, so then you select the two columns, right click, and choose unpivot. Bam. So now I have the attribute that I want to select, that I want to filter or slice by, which is my product and my color. And then I have the value, which I'm going to put on my axis, right? Every corresponding color and every corresponding product. That's it. Simple as that. I'm going to click close and apply. Okay. give Power BI a chance to do everything it needs to do, right? And then if you go over to your relationships, you're gonna see, right? Because I persist my product key, it's gonna automatically create a one-to-many relationship between product and product unpivot. So cool, this is cool, right? So now what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna go to my page in the report. Let me change my view here to actual size, just so you can see, and I don't have to do a whole bunch of formatting. So you can see, if you're like me, you got contacts, so I got four sets of eyes, right? So now I have my unpivot table, and what I wanna do is I wanna have the attribute as a slicer. So you can see it shows product and color. I'm gonna go ahead and make that a slicer. For all you guys, you can see that. And then I'm gonna make a bar chart with the values on the bar chart, okay? And then I'm gonna add sales. Uh-oh, we got a problem, right? And you can easily solve this problem. It's like doing a Cartesian product because I don't have bi-directional filters turned on, bi-directional relationship. So I can go here and turn on my bi-directional relationship. And I'm gonna say something here in a little bit that's kind of funny. I go turn it on and now it's working. Now, if you talk to my man, Marco, right? If you guys don't know Marco, go check out his blog post, SQL BI, his website, DAX patterns, all the products. This guy's a DAX genius. He goes, don't use, he didn't say don't. He goes, be careful when you use it. And he gave me an option, right? He and I were hanging out at the past summit. He's like, you should use CrossFilter, Patrick. So let's do this. Let's turn this off. I'm gonna go ahead and turn off bi-directional filtering, cross filtering, turn that off, right? Break some stuff, I'm gonna break some stuff. And so I'm gonna, now it's everything's broken, right? But I'm gonna create a new measure, I'm gonna call it sales dynamic, right? Like me, I'm pretty dynamic, don't you think? So I'm gonna choose modeling, click new measure. Let's call this sales dynamic. Yep, I'm about to type some DAX live in a demo. I'm gonna say calculate, and I'm gonna do, already have sales. So I'm gonna say calculate the sales. And what I'm gonna use is cross filter. This is what my man told me to use. Marco said, use cross filter. And I'm gonna cross filter on the product key, and the product pivot, and the product key. And I'm gonna say both directions, just like that, right? So wrote a little DAX. Now check this out. I put it on the wrong table. That's okay, right? Click go to change my home table to my internet sales, internet sales. I need to fix that before I do a new video, but I'm not starting over. You guys know what I'm talking about, right? Here's my table. Go ahead and add it. You can see how it works. I'm gonna get rid of this crazy sales table. Nice, make this a nice little bar chart. Bam, now watch this. Here's the magic. I want you guys to pay attention. Pay attention, right? If I click product, only products. If I click color, only color. Now, when I publish this and give my end users access to this, they can automatically toggle between the attributes that they want to see on the axis, automatically, right? I don't have to do anything, I don't have to change anything, they don't have to go into edit mode, they can do this write and read mode, right? What do you guys think? How are you doing this today? Do you have a better solution, something more elegant? Hit me up, hit me up, write some comments below, post them in the comments below, let me know. I'd be happy to, you know, even maybe make a video based on your solution and give you a shout out. This is good stuff, right? We work together as a team. Scott, Chris, and myself, we came together, we put our minds together. Scott started us off, Chris had the question, I finished it up with a little Power Query and then produced the video. All right, so like I said, you got any questions, comments, post it in the comments below. This is your first time visiting the channel, be sure to subscribe, right? Why not, right? And if you like my video, give it a big thumbs up. As always, from Adam and Patrick, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.
Thumbnail, 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 thumbnail. Oh, where's my fidget spinner?